Start game now.
Welcome, retro fans, to another edition of the No Score Gamer. Bob the Lobster's here today because he tells me he's a pretty big basketball fan. And that's because we're going to look at Dubble Dwibble for your Nintendo Entertainment System. Looking at the box art here, or the label art, looks pretty standard. It's about a white guy who's trying to overcome the discrimination of white men not being able to jump, taking on, it looks like, guys from white jersey, green jersey, yellow jersey, blue jersey, from four different teams all at the same time, maybe five too. There's another guy down there, kind of blurry. So quite the adventure there. Let's go ahead and put this all-American game into our Nintendo Entertainment System and see if it's any good or not. Let's go to the game. Dubble Dwibble is from Konami. It came to the Nintendo Entertainment System in 1987 and is actually based on an arcade game of the same name that was out in 1986. It is a 5-on-5 basketball game where you can select one of four teams. Those four teams are Los Angeles, Boston, Chicago, or New York. But shh, don't tell anybody, they're actually supposed to be based on NBA teams, but they didn't have the license. Dubble Dwibble is for one or two players. If you're playing a single player game, you can choose from three levels of difficulty, level 1, 2, and 3, with level 3 being the most difficult of them. You can also select how long you want the periods being, from 5 minutes to 10 minutes to 20 minutes or 30 minutes. When you start the game on offense, you use the B button to shoot. You hold it down to start your shot and let it go to release it, but if you don't let it go, you'll be called for traveling. You can also use the A button to pass. It'll pass towards the closest person to you that is flashing wherever you are aimed at. On defense, use the B button to switch defenders, and the A button is used for stealing. So basically what you have here is a pretty standard basketball game where you can score two-pointers or three-pointers if you are beyond the arc, and occasionally you can shoot free throws when fouled. Now they actually have an interesting game mechanic when shooting free throws. There is a little halo that kind of bounces up and down over the rim, and you want to shoot it right when the halo is touching the rim. I actually thought this was a really clever way of doing free throws, and one of my favorite ways of doing free throws in any basketball game so far. I like it a whole lot better than the team meter that was used in later games. Graphically speaking, the game is not that impressive on the outside, but if you are close enough to the rim when shooting, it will automatically stop and you'll get a little movie or cinematic of a guy jamming the ball. It's kind of like a strobe light effect. It's not very smooth. It's like a few images pasted together one after another, but I can imagine it was really cool at the time, and I did enjoy seeing them when trying out this game. Also, during halftime, you will get to see a little halftime show featuring some cheerleaders and the mascots chasing each other. However, an interesting aspect is that you cannot skip the halftime show. They force you to watch it, which is kind of a bummer. After you watch it a few times, you might want to skip ahead, and now you're forced to watch it. But oh well, it is what it is. The music and sounds are pretty basic. I did like the sound of the jamming of the basketball. And at the beginning of the game, you get a nice digitized voice saying, "Dubble Dwibble," which is kind of humorous as well. This game is fairly cheap on eBay. Loose copies commonly go for $4 to $5, including shipping, and complete copies went for $10 to $15. So it should be too hard to find a cheap copy of Dubble Dwibble if that is what you're going for. Over on Facebook and Twitter, I asked people what they thought of the game, and this is what they said. Aaron said, "Dubble Dwibble," making fun of the digitized voice. Matt said that it is one of his all-time favorite classic sport titles, and he thought that the dunks were amazing back in the day, and I could totally understand that. Michael from Two Dudes in a Nest said that he played it so much when he was about 6 years old, but he hasn't touched it since. And I'm wondering how many people haven't touched it since, considering that it was a pretty popular game when the NES came out. Eric also commented on the Dubble Dwibble, and Ross said that it's the best FMV game on the NES. Yeah, it is kind of like FMV-ish when they do the dunks. Derek said, "It's a pass. LOL, okay, I'm done." So, haha, it's a pass because it's basketball and never mind. And Nick from the Genesis Gem says that it's great as a kid, but it doesn't quite hold up well over time. And I think I'm kind of in line with you there, Nick. Retro Nonsense said that it was the first game he ever bought with his own money, and that he played countless hours of this little gem, and that's Konami at its best. Very interesting that it's his first game he bought. I think that's kind of cool. Danny made reference to the fact that it says Dubble Dwibble at the title screen, and that was very amazing. And he says it's a great game too, with the cinema dunks. And Rad Retro Gaming said that it's awesome. So what did I think of this game? Well, you know what? Here's the deal. I did not really play this game when I was younger. I didn't have a Nintendo growing up. I did play it at a friend's house, but I really didn't have a lot of exposure to it. So this is from someone who's playing it for the first time. And maybe it's just me. I respect everyone's opinion, and hopefully you'll respect mine, but I just didn't have a lot of fun with the game because I found it very difficult to gain control of. When I was playing it, I found it very hard to get a feel for the game, and every time I played it, I basically got beat whether I was playing against a person or the computer at the easiest level. There was even one time that when I was going in for a dunk and I'd see that cinematic show up and I kept hitting bricks off the dunk. I'd get the rebound, try again, and I kept bricking it every single time. And I kind of thought that, hey, if you get the little movie, it should go in, right? But no, not at all. So I just had a hard time getting into it and a very hard time mastering it. Now, sometimes difficult games can be fun, but I really didn't enjoy it. I wonder if it's one of those games where, like Nick was saying, where when you're younger, you really like and the nostalgia is really strong with it. But if you were to pick it up today, if it wouldn't hold up as well. Or maybe I just need to give it some more time to getting used to. But it's not a game that's drawing me in that I really want to give more time. I'd rather play something like Atari 7800's one-on-one basketball or even NBA Jam. Now, from what I do understand, though, if you do get a hold of the control scheme, it can get pretty easy, and there are some sweet spots supposedly on the court where you can just nail one shot after the other. And if you are able to pass a defender, usually it's very easy to break away as well, but I was just not able to get a hang of it. So for me personally, it's a pass, but if you're nostalgic for this one, it's pretty cheap. You can find it easy. I'm curious to find out, tell me in the comments below if you played it recently and if it still holds up as well as you remember. So where am I going to rank this family-friendly game? Well, on my list of games that I've already reviewed, I'm looking kind of in the middle, maybe lower middle area. I'd rather play Anticipation. I had more enjoyment with that game. But you know what? I think I'd rather play this and Friday the 13th and trying to face Jason again. Both games are really difficult, but I'd probably get a little more enjoyment out of Dubble Dwibble. So Dubble Dwibble is going to be my new number 11 game. Yep, opinions may vary on this one, but that's just mine. If you enjoy reviews like this, even if you disagree with my opinion, would you go ahead and click the like and subscribe button? I'd appreciate that. And you can also follow me on the Facebook or the Twitter. Just go to either one and search for The Nose for Gamer. Thank you for giving me a little part of your day, and I look forward to seeing you next time right here on The Nose for Gamer. Take care, everybody. Dubble Dwibble.